Overtime here, 1-1 the score, game one of the ECAC quarterfinals. Here comes Ilkchuk and Husar on a 2-on-1. Ilkchuk with it, shot, scores! Chelsea Ilkchuk on the 2-on-1 beats Vanderbleek, and the Bobcats win it 2-1.
She was on a 2-on-1 with Husar on the left. The defender did a great job of taking away the passing lane, which left Ilkchuk wide open to take that shot, and got deflected off the goalie, but it went in, and we're thankful for it.
Chelsea Ilkchuk, the sophomore out of Lockport, Manitoba, with the game-winning goal, only had two on the season, but none bigger than that one right there, and she gives the Bobcats a 1-0 lead in the series, and the Bobcats able to take down RPI in the first game. And they'll be back tomorrow, Robin. It's a pretty quick turnaround. They play tomorrow at 2.
Well, yeah, but I was telling Jamie during the intermission, excuse me, it's not like you just played a team like you do in the regular season, then you have to travel somewhere else and you play a different team the next game. Both these teams just went through those two overtimes, one and a half. They both just did that. They both spent the same amount of energy, and I mean, I don't think there's an advantage that way. I think the Bobcats are going to have all the momentum with this goal now for tomorrow.
All right, we'll take a break, come back, and if they're up to it, we'll see if we can get some interviews here. You're listening to the Bobcat Sports Network, presented by WQAQ.
Joined now by head coach Rick Seely with a smile on his face after a double overtime win. Chelsea Ilkchuk gets the game-winning goal. Coach, thanks for joining us.
Good to be here.
Coach, think back to what seems about like a lifetime and a half ago, first and second period, and it just seemed like there wasn't much energy. Do you have any idea what that could have been, what that was about?
No, I was trying to figure it out for about 50 minutes. I thought we finally kicked it into gear about halfway through the third. You know, it could be nerves. None of them have been here before, even the seniors. We had a good week of practice. Not sure, but it's playoff hockey, and we got a couple good bounces.
And Chelsea Ilkchuk scores the game-winning goal, but you know, you have to give her credit for the first goal as well, what she did to draw that penalty and set up the power play.
Yeah, absolutely, and that gave us the boost, really. She created the whole thing, and it was a good, I think, pass from, I forget the right winger, made a good outlet to her, and just drove to the net, and obviously that changed with about, 5.5 minutes left.
When you're in a game like this, obviously, you know, none of your players have played this type of extended overtime hockey, at least at the collegiate level. How does your game plan change when you're playing for such an extended period of time? Not only that, but knowing about the quick turnaround that you have tomorrow.
Well, I mean, our game's all about high energy, and it's just hard to sustain that for five periods in the forecheck. So I thought we played a little smarter, and when we had the chances, that's when we exploded. We didn't waste a lot of energy, but I've talked to the team all year about this. I said, we gotta get in shape to play three overtime period games in basically 48 hours. So we don't change anything. I think it gives us a huge advantage over them the next 2 days, and we'll see how it goes tomorrow.
And, Coach, you know, talking a little bit about that, you have those one and possibly two games coming up. What did you see today that, you know, you can definitely look to improve on in the next two games?
Well, our energy in the first two periods. It's a great group of student athletes, and they're serious. I just don't think our focus was there when we started today. I just think it was too vast. And I think now that, you know, the nerves are out of the way, they've got one game under their belt, I think they go home tonight and focus a lot more on what we're trying to accomplish.
All right, Coach, thanks for joining us. Good luck tomorrow. We'll see you then.
Thanks very much.
All right, Coach Rick Seely there with us as Bobcats take down RPI in the first game of this series, 2-1. As we bring back in Robin Schuppert. And Robin, you know, Coach Seely said it. They had no energy the first two periods, you know, pretty much the first half of the third period as well. They found their stride late in the game, and they were able to take home this victory.
Yeah, and we mentioned those things during the game. They just looked very tired out there. They didn't look like they had a lot of energy. And you know, that play by Chelsea Ilkchuk really changed the game for them. They got the power play, they got the goal, and ever since then, they were the dominant team. They dominated the final 4 minutes of regulation. They dominated the first overtime, and they dominated the first 10 minutes of the second overtime, and eventually got that goal.
And so the Bobcats women's ice hockey team will be back in action tomorrow afternoon, 2 o'clock start time. Jamie Palatini and Brian Farrell will have the call for you as the Bobcats, with a win in that game, will clinch a berth in the semifinals here in the ECAC as this magical season for this team continues.
Yeah, and that would be a great thing, and most likely it would be on the road, so we wouldn't be able to watch it here firsthand. They wouldn't have the home ice, but Cornell, the higher seed, took care of business today in pretty much every game. Cornell won, Clarkson won, Quinnipiac won. Princeton Harvard just got going, but if all the top seeds win, Quinnipiac's going to have to go on the road, and they're a great team at home, so we'll see how they do on the road.
We talked about it a little bit with Coach Seeley, but this is a team that comes out, they play a very poor first two periods. They're able to somehow grind it out and win a game that they really, didn't have any business winning, but they're able to get a win not playing anywhere near their best hockey.
Well, yeah, halfway through the third period, you and I talked about the fact that this team was playing the worst game of its season, and yet they were still down 1-0. They were still in the middle of the game, and then after the third period, they realized, boy, we just played the worst game of the season, and we're tied at 1. I mean, anybody still in it? They picked it up, and they came back to get it.
All right, so the Bobcats win game 1, 2-1. We'll take one more break, come back, hopefully with Chelsea Oakchuk. You're listening to the Bobcats Sports Network, presented by WQAQ. All right, welcome back to the broadcast here. I'm Corey Hersch, and joined by Chelsea Oakchuk, scorer of the game-winning goal here in this one. Chelsea, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm sure you're probably doing pretty good.
Great.
In a game like this, where you're playing extended overtimes, I'm sure the fatigue factor is there. How do you play through that?
Yeah, well, with our the whole season, we've just had a lot of hard work and practice, so that really kept us in there and gave us an advantage over them for sure.
You come in on the 2-on-1 with Evelina, and it looked to us that they cut down the passing lane, and so just ripped the shot, right?
Yeah, the first look I was going for was the pass, but then Coach always says pick that one spot, so I was going blocker side just inside the post, so.
And, finally, Callie scores the goal to tie it in the third period, but, you were the one that drew the penalty. Talk a little bit about what you saw. Your team's out on a change, and you just went to the net hard.
Yeah, well, Coach is always saying just drive to the net, and then some good things will happen. So that's what I did, and I was lucky that they drew a penalty.
Right, looking to tomorrow, a chance to win, advance in the playoffs. What do you think you can do tomorrow to improve on your chances in the game on Saturday?
Well, I think if we just come out the way we did in the third and all the overtimes, I think we'll have a good advantage because right now we have the momentum, so.
All right, Chelsea, congratulations. Get some rest. Come back tomorrow.
Okay, thank you.
Chelsea Ilchuk here on the Bobcat Sports Network, presented by WQAQ. Bring back in Robin one more time before we take a little bit of a break ourselves, come back and do the men's game, Robin, what do you see from this team that they can look to improve on tomorrow?
Well, I mean, the energy needs to pick up in the first and second periods, but the one thing I'm going to be looking forward to tomorrow is just the endurance and conditioning of both teams. We saw today the Bobcats really started playing better as the game went on. You got to imagine that both teams are going to be pretty tired tomorrow, and, the better conditioned team will come out of the gates and get the first goal and win this game.
All right, that'll do it for us. Come back in about half an hour or so from now, and we'll have the men's game for you against Brown. For Kyle Brennan and Robin Schuppert, I'm Corey Hersch. Quinnipiac beats RPI 2-1 in double overtime, and we'll be right back.